sports. It's in the game.
Better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want.
And we are at Bill Stadium in upstate New York. The folks in Buffalo love their Bills, and a moment ago they entered to the delight of this sold-out crowd. They're set for football as their Bills will do battle with the Cincinnati Bengals. And we are underway in Buffalo. Brandon Wilson now from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped it to 23. Down. Here's Burrow. Over the middle, that's caught by Chase. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Looking for Higgins, but it is intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And it's a terrific return here as he's going to have him set up with a first and goal right at about the 6-yard line. Offensively, a far from ideal start there with a pick on the opening drive.
Yeah, not exactly what they were looking for. We know that. That's pretty obvious. The beauty, though, is it's happening early. If they don't panic, they don't compound this problem, they've got a long way to go and a chance to get back in it.
Suddenly it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. They run here with Singletary. He gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the six inside the five to the four. Second and goal from inside the five. Now Allen. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Throwing now is Allen. And it's caught. Touchdown! Dawson Knox, a touchdown grab from Josh Allen. And the Bills have taken the early lead.
For good reason, quarterbacks want to get the ball to the perimeter to their wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, it felt like, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football. And for good reason.
Now they'll line up to kick the extra point. And it's 7-0 Buffalo. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. From his end zone, Wilson. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Bengals drive about to get going. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35.
A good run there off right tackle in an old school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Joe Mixon. And he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of this caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Flush to his right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Gregory Rousseau. Able to get in there and run him down for what's going to be a loss of 15 yards all told. So that'll leave Burrow and the Bengals with a third and long after that sack we just saw. They'll look to throw. Into the secondary, past the 40. And he gets this only to the 41. Not near enough for the first. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Fourth and goal, and down by a touchdown, the offense stays on the field. Burrow going for it on fourth. Got a man. It's Chase. He completes it. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. That's caught by the tight end, Drew Sample. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Mixon with a first down carry. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Line, 2nd and 9. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 43 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. Working the middle here, that's complete to Sample, the tight end. A good pick up there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
On second down, here's Mixon. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He winds up giving a yard back there, and now it's 3rd and 2.
That was well played there defensively. 2 tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Joe Mixon, a 15-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And we are tied here in the 2nd quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. McKenzie will not return this and it'll be brought out to the 25. Ready to go for their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
And he's going to have a Bills first down as he's got this up to the 40-yard line.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at 7. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. A run on first down, but it's not going to get him much, maybe a yard, and that's all. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Allen. Eluding the pressure right. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third. Here's Allen to throw it. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 5 yards on the screen, but that'll take us to fourth down.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception, and that means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to him and hold him for just a short gain.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. He's got the connection to Cole Beasley. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown.
Well, we know that he can beat you in a number of ways. He can catch it short. He can take it longer. He can do what we just saw right there, catch it, and then run with the football.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Bengals drive about to get going.
And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range.
The Burrow's throw caught by Higgins. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. To throw again on second down, Burrow. And his throw is incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. Burrow will throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout, as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. So on fourth down, on comes the left-footed punter, Kevin Huber, to punt it away. Isaiah McKenzie is back deep for the Bills. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive.
And with great starting field position up near the 50, they might be one completion away from stealing a late field goal here.
Now a throw to the end
zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try and throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
To throw on second and 10. Allen. And he's taken down at the 50 after a short gain of 2. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Final adjustments being made for the second half. So with that, we get you back up to Orchard Park and rejoin Brandon and Charles.
Welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Bills with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. A fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. The third quarter starts with a run by Singletary, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. The last run got a couple here, second and 8. They go right back to Singletary, and he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. They'll try and run for this with Singletary. And he's going to have a Bills first down as he's able to get this up past the 40.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Larry Ogunjobi there to make the tackle. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. Throwing is Allen on third. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterward to just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, gives an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
Extra point by Bass, up and good, and it's now 21-7. And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bengals drive about to get going. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
Second and 10. Now it's Burrow. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. This goes out wide for Mixon. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. The call here. They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it with Burrow. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Bills are going to take over in excellent field position. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Allen's throw taken in by Diggs. So the pitch and catch good for 11. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. On the give, this is Singletary. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
Muscle damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell three times with passing touchdowns. But guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
On first down, they stick with Singletary. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. It's Logan Wilson there to bring him down. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. On the handoff, it's Singletary. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. It'll be first and goal when we come back. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
This is obviously a critical sequence for this defense if they want to stay in this game. Down 2 scores already. They give up a touchdown here. That makes things really difficult for their offense moving forward.
And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Mike Hilton. And the Bengals are right back in this football game. 2-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy, because with a 2-score lead, you think maybe just sitting on and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. That's complete to the tight end Sample. And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24. On first and 10, Joe Burrow. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there.
And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way down to the 26. A big play there for Cincinnati. Now Burrow on first down. And he'll go right back to Chase. That's caught again. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
From the red zone now, here's Burrow first down. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing again, it's Burrow. Open man is Higgins. And he's brought down.
This defense has certainly had an outstanding second half, haven't they? I know they just gave up a first down there for the offense. They're hoping that that's something they can jumpstart with and maybe start to move the ball a little bit better. But it's been tough sledding for them here the entire second half.
Mixon again, and he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. Joe Mixon, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bengals have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Bengals 14. So a 7-point game, they'll need a recovery, the touchdown, and an extra point to tie. And the Bills are going to recover. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Now he dumps this off over the middle, and he's going to get this inside the 30. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. They'll run on first down with Singletary. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line.
Well, that kind of hit will certainly fire up your team both on the field and on the sideline. Tackles for lost yardage, they're always welcome.
Looking at a 2nd-and-11 now after the loss. So Allen's going to look to throw. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six for a Bengals TD.
That was a nice catch, and not by the guy you thought it was going to be. How about the defender turning into an offensive player as soon as the ball hits his hands, and off he goes, off to the races, and into the end zone.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good, and we are tied here in the fourth quarter. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the fourth quarter, picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time, and that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
Allen. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Well, first down, screen pass, good for 5.
Boy, that was certainly well-read defensively. And the key to any screen play is space to work. And there was none to be found there. And they tackle him for just a short gain.
Second and 5. Allen. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. There have been quite a few plays they might look back on and say, we really have hurt ourselves, and that was another example.
And this is late game execution. Everything on the line, so it all has to come together properly. The throw's made. Where's the catch? Got to catch in that spot.
Now Allen. That'll be complete to Breida. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Throwing is Allen. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's 2nd down. They'll run out of the gun with Singletary, and he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up 3rd down. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. So 3rd down and a field goal from here would be right about 50 yards as they try to get closer. Here's Allen. And that will be incomplete.
And I know they would have loved to have had a touchdown there to give them some cushion. But now, kick the field goal. Get the lead. Let your defense bring you home. Show some faith in those guys on the other side of the ball.
Bit of a pressure spot here for Tyler Bass.
This to almost certainly win the football game.
The kick by Bass is good.
And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute.
So they hadn't called on him at all until this point, but he comes through here and buries one from long range.
Yeah, that's awfully impressive because usually kickers like to get that first one out of their system in the first quarter, sort of get them into the flow of the game. But to come in this late and knock it down from long distance, give him a lot of credit.
The Bengals drive about to get going. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking two plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one, whether you're able to get into field goal range or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary. But you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
Let's see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. Burrow. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And the Bills have just about sewn up this football game.
When you talk about making winning plays, that is a winning play at this stage of the game. To come up with that interception, huge.
I like how you identified that because most people think winning plays are the offense trying to get it done. In this case, nursing a lead, they found a way to make a play on that side of the ball and maybe finish things off.
So it's a victory here for the Buffalo Bills. And it wasn't really always pretty. They had their bumps and bruises. Really, both sides did. But they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind this one out, didn't they? Because nothing came easy. Every snap was a major league brawl. They had to win in the line of scrimmage, win downfield. They got all those things accomplished. But to win a close one like this, you know, every team wants to be physical. We've heard that a million times, right? But those who are mentally tough, those are the teams that you have to deal with in the playoffs. This was that type of a game.